What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to the channel. My name is Tristan. Hope you guys do enjoy your stay here. Today, coming at you guys with another Call of Duty Vanguard video. Today, what we're going to be doing is playing with one of the best SMGs in the game, that being the M1928, one of my favorites in terms of things. And I think a lot of you guys are really going to like this. We just had a new playlist come out because of Season 3, so this is going to be really fun. We're going to hop into some Shiphouse 24/7, see how we do. Let's get to it.
Oh my god, I couldn't speak there. Alright, let's see who we can get over here, guys.
What?
Okay, yeah, he's over here in this corner, I guarantee you, watch. Yep, there he is. Okay. Finally picking up the pace here, let's go. Ooh, we're playing another YouTuber, let's go. That's even better, man. Nice little Molotov kill. Ah, that guy got a good kill on me. Okay. Been gone the last couple days because of just terrible issues. I'm gonna try to push up here. I should have got that kill, man. It's okay. Throw that. Get one elimination. Hopefully, we can try to get, like, someone else. Ooh, okay. There we go. I'm surprised we were able to actually get out of there when we did. Okay. Okay. Careful. Let's go. Throw that over there. Nice. I think they're moving on A. Or at least it seemed like they were trying to. Okay. Bro, that could have went either way, but that's okay, I guess. Let's play this very smart here. Nice. Easy low headshot. Ah, the guy had to shoot me in the back. That's okay. Alright, there we go. Ooh, okay. Back-to-back headshot. Dang it, man! Hopefully I didn't get all my streaks. That's unfortunate. We're probably getting close to getting full streaks. Alright, come on. Let's see. Here we go. Nice. Ooh. Okay. Okay. We're definitely trading a lot more than we should be, but we're at least still getting kills. Let's see here. No way I hit that guy. Let's go. We got that kill. That was sick. Aw, and that headshot right there was nasty too. Let's go, man. Alright. There we go. There we go. Nice little long shot. Okay. There we go. Getting our streaks again, let's go. Okay. We can get these guys off the, like, head glitches and stuff. Ooh, okay. Nice, there we go. We gotta play this very carefully here. Let's go, let's go! Oh, baby, we hit that triple! Oh my god, man! And we got the full streaks. Let's go, dude. Let's see here. Nice. Okay. Bro, this guy literally had a death machine in his face. How did he still kill me? I find that hilarious. The death machine does, like, absolutely no damage to people at close range. Gonna call in the dog here as well, guys. We'll get rid of the remaining bullets in this death machine as well, because there's at least some people we can probably kill, get a couple, like, extra kills, maybe. Okay. I'm not trying to be around this spot too much, but it also does kind of help a lot. We gotta try to keep the complexity of this match going and, like, the vibe of it. Oh, man, I keep dying. Like, you know, getting into a good position and then start dying. It's kind of unfortunate, for sure. I think this guy's right behind us, too. Alright, teammates got him. That's good. Teammates got this guy again. Let's play this carefully. What? I literally was shooting at that guy's torso. Bro, I swear the hit and wreck in this game is absolutely terrible. Overall, though, guys, it is a brand new season of Vanguard. Season 3 has finally come out, so that's a great thing. This guy bunny hopped me and just literally... Wow, okay. But yeah, guys, I mean, Season 3 is finally here, and, you know, there's a ton of amazing stuff I can't wait to make content on, new maps, new guns, everything. And definitely, I think we're going to have, like, a lot of fun getting ready for the new Call of Duty game. So, that was a nasty headshot. I didn't even see where that guy was. Okay, there we go. We got that guy. I'm going to play careful here. Okay, nice. Okay. I need to reload here. We at least got the 60 bomb, okay. Maybe we can drag this game out. Probably isn't going to happen. But, I mean, hey, still, 60 bomb is not bad. We definitely could have easily got a 70 bomb. But this lobby is, like, full of tryhards and missed kills, man. So, it's definitely unfortunate. Not too bad, man. 63 kills. Okay. Alright, everyone. So, that was the gameplay. Hopefully, you guys did enjoy it. Now, what I want to do is show you guys every attachment and the entire class setup as a whole and really show you guys how dominant this class is. Alright, guys. So, starting off with the muzzle, we're going to be using the M1929 silencer. The reason why I like this one is because it gives +1 sound suppression and +1 accuracy. You are going to lose 1 point of aim down sight speed, but that's not necessarily going to be a bad thing. Now for the barrel, guys, we're going to be using the CGC 12-inch cooling barrel. The reason why I like this one particularly is because it's highly accurate and controllable. It has a reduced scope sway and a gun bob as well, which really is going to help out a lot with the accuracy. You are going to lose sprint to fire and hip fire accuracy, but unless you're rushing and trying to be very fast-paced, that's not going to matter as much. For the optic, guys, we're using the slate reflector. The reason why I love this one is because it has that 1.35 times magnification. It's small as a rectangular sight and a precision sight picture, which is relatively going to help out a lot. For the stock, we're going to be using the CGC wire grip. Now, the reason why I like this one is because it's going to give you +4 aim walking movement, aim walking steadiness speed, 1 point of aim down sight speed, and 1 point of initial accuracy and recoil. When it comes to the cons, you're going to be losing 3 points of sprint to fire speed, 2 points of hip fire accuracy, and 1 point of accuracy and recoil during sustained fire. But as you guys can tell across the board, again, it's going to really help out with both the vertical and horizontal recoil, that idle sway control, and that movement speed across the board. For the underbarrel, I'm using the Mark VI Skeletal, and the reason why I'm using this one in particular is just because it has the +1 aim down sight speed, which is really just going to help out a lot. I know some people do like using the M1941 hand stop, or sometimes I might go and use the Carver foregrip, but regardless, across the board, it is up to you, whatever one you really wish to use. Now for the magazine, guys, we're going to be using the 9mm 50 round drums. And this is where the speed and the accuracy really do a lot of good for you. You're going to get +5 points of recoil control and accuracy, +2 aim down sight speed and fire rate, and +1 movement speed. You're going to lose 1 point of bullet penetration and damage, and then 2 points of bullet velocity and range. But across the board, as you guys can see, again, the recoil control already insane as it has been so far. And then that starting ammo capacity is increased. The movement speed across the board is increased. The only big things, again, are that damage and so forth. Ammo type, we're going to be using the FMJ rounds, and this is to help a little bit with that bullet penetration and really overall give it a better vibe. Most of the ammo types in here, besides the lengthened, are really not going to do much for you, and even if you use the lengthened one, as you guys can see, you're going to lose 50% penetration damage. So that is something that you guys have to keep in mind. Now for the rear grip, we're going to be using the taped grip. And personally for me, I like this one because it has +3 aiming stability and +1 weapon swap quickness. So that's really going to help out a lot. 42.3% in the idle sway control. Now I know that some people do like using the polymer grip or like using the granular grip. It really just depends on what you really like to use. For the proficiency, we're using fleet. This is going to help with +1 weapon swap quickness and +1 movement speed. I know that some people do like using frenzy, which will give you health regeneration after kills, which definitely does come in handy. So I'll end up putting that one on there. And then lastly, guys, for the kit, we're using fully loaded, which is going to give you max starting ammo right out the gate. So really going to help you out in every possible gunfight. Now for perks, guys, I'm using Ninja for my tactics, and the reason why is to move around the map silently. Some people do like using Ghost. It really just depends on what you're trying to do. In this case, I'll probably switch it over to Ghost. For the Intel perk, I'm using Piercing Vision, which is basically so if I hit a enemy and I don't kill them, I can still see where they are and pick them off. And then lastly, guys, I'm using Scavenger as my third perk. And you guys know what Scavenger does. And then additionally, using a Molotov cocktail and a stun grenade for the lethals and tacticals. So overall, guys, that was the class setup and the gameplay and everything together. So let me know what you guys thought in the comment section down below. But with that being said, guys, my name is Tristan Taze. Leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you guys are brand new. And I'll see all of you guys in the next one.